Gotta wait till they come up. Or they come back.
Thank you. really get a good understanding of the highway.
So to get us started, all lighthouses in orbit that occupy the Great Lakes surrounding the world are all trying to send one of two messages to the sailors in the water. That message is either come this direction or to stay away. And here on Mackinac Point, the message that they were trying to send was to stay away. The reason is, if you look behind me in the water out there, you can tell there's almost a difference in the color out there. There's the lighter area and then there's that darker area. The lighter area is the shallow part, and that shallow part wraps around the northern ship up here. Before 1889, the flight station got its start, they feared ships could possibly cut the corner off of the east side too early and could run aground and wreck. So they're using four methods, one of which was the fog signal, to send that message to sailors in the water. But the other three I'm going to talk about first. The first method they're using was called a day mark. Day marks are used when you can't use the light during the day, and if there's no fog, you're not going to turn the fog signal on either. So you just use the building itself, the lighthouse. Each lighthouse, in two or few of them, you'll notice that they all look different, whether that's a structural difference or color scheme difference, that's all done on purpose, so you can see it during the day and know which each one was. So for instance, our day mark is the red roof, the green colored brick, the black lantern roof, and it also looks like a castle on the outside. The second method was through light, called a light sequence or light signature. Here on Mackinac Point, we originally had a fourth order size lens, meaning that it's your standard size lens you can see out in the Great Lakes. Sometimes those orders go from second orders, which are these huge lenses, all the way down to sixth order for shoot on game day. And here on Mackinac Point, we had a fourth order size lens, and that lens would be located up in the lantern room of the lighthouse. It had only these sequence. Originally, it was a red light that flashed for 10 seconds once every minute, and then they switched to a white one later on. The third method that they're using to send that was through radio signal. Here at Mackinac Point, we originally had a 132-foot radio beacon tower that was placed in 1937, 1938, down to where that green sign is today. Looking over that direction, it was one out of three in the area that ships could triangulate their positions using the radio signal that gave off, and they could navigate through the Straits of Mackinac. Our signal that we gave off in Morse code was through dashes. And the fourth method was through fog signal. This building that you see over here today is a 1906 fog signal building, and it's not the original one that was here. The original one was built in 1890, and it sat where the benches are today, around about this area. You're probably wondering, well, if that's the original one, where's that? Well, there were some things wrong with that first one. One, the whistle was on the south end of the building, rather than on the north end, so all that noise would have traveled out toward the village when it needed to go out toward the lake. And then, in 1892, they built the lighthouse, and they noticed that the two were too close together, and that the lighthouse was blocking the sound from traveling out toward the water. Well, in 1892, they then decided that they needed to separate the two, and they decided to separate the smaller of the two. Notice, the lighthouse is pretty big, pretty good size, and the fog signal that was originally here was much smaller, so they decided to move it away from it. There's another problem. In 1892, the property that you see today was much smaller back then. The original property line went from where that fence turns the corner, went all the way to the back fence back there. So everything on that side of the fence was owned by the village of Mackinac City, or part of the public park that was here. Well, at that time, Mackinac City did not want to give it to the government for free, and the government did not want to pay for the property of it, so that started an 11-year legal battle between the two entities. And in 1905, Congress appropriated the funds for $50,000. They purchased the property, built the fog signal building in 1906, and it was first used in November of 1907. The original one that sat here was then moved back to our shipwreck museum in this day. That building is a reconstructed version of it. The original one was torn down in the 1930s. So just like the lighthouse called the Daymark, the light signature up in the lantern room, the radio beacon, the fog signal had its own unique sequence called a sound sequence. Historically, it was a 5-second blast followed by 17 seconds of silence, followed by another 5-second blast followed by 33 seconds of silence, which consisted of 1 minute. Now, that minute could repeat itself. Sometimes the blasting could last for an hour, sometimes it could last for a day. One time, though, there were fires in the Upper Peninsula, and winds pushed the smoke this direction, which caused a dense fog to cover the area. That blasting lasted for 1 week. And then, located inside the building, we'll talk about the building real quick, located inside the building would have been two locomotive-sized steam engines. One was your primary one, and then the other one was your backup one. Originally, they were wood-burning, and then they switched to coal later on. And then there was also a steam boiler located inside that building as well. Then, in the 1930s, you look up on the roof, you'll notice there's a platform on the roof. That's where our air horns used to sit. The air horns are no longer there, but the platform is still up there today, as you can see it. So you're probably wondering, what was the set standard for them to sound off the whistle? There was none. It was on the discretion of the lighthouse keeper. So take, for instance, if he could not see Round Island or Mackinac Island from here, he would sound off the whistle. So with that being said, if you'd like to follow me, we're going to get a closer look at the whistle from down here. So if you want to scoot on over close to the fence, get a good look at it. Remember, the closer it gets, the louder it is. So, here's our whistle. It is originally it was a 10-inch size diameter whistle, meaning it was a standard size whistle. This one is not. I think it's about a 14-inch size diameter. The reason why I thought the original one is when they put the air horns on the roof of the building, they took the original whistle away, so this is the replacement one. But this is what it would have been at the time. Unlike today, we're not using steam to run our whistle, we're using compressed air. So, because that steam would corrode that whistle, we want to keep ours longer. So, unlike today, the sound's going to be a little bit higher pitch compared to what it historically been, which would have been lower pitch with that whistle. But it doesn't matter, it all depends on that sound sequence. So, it's the timing that's more important than the actual sound itself. So how it works is you take that air or steam, you push through the pipes, it comes up, it rattles that cylindrical round piece which is on the outside. That round piece then creates those air sound frequencies that we pick up with our eardrums. Those sound frequencies then react with the molecules in the air, which then creates those sound waves. Those sound waves then start getting bigger and bigger and bigger, which then helps carry that distance further away. You'll be able to hear it and actually sound it off. Speaking of which, I will now sound it off three times. I would recommend closing your ears because it can hear between 128 decibels of sound. And if you want a really good laugh, watch the people out on the beach because they're not expecting this. But I will warn them just to be on the safe side so I don't get cold. Sound me in the fog horn! Sound me in the fog horn! So I'm going to start in 10 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thank you.